Welcome back. In today's tutorial, we will see what happens when initiator sends the first message of IKE exchange. What information is shared in that first packet? So let's get to it.
Here in this setup, we have two ASAs. So in first packet, what information does the initiator send to the responder? In first packet, it sends cookies. Second thing is phase one proposals, and it sends NAT. It also sends a few more things, DOI, domain of interpretation, and situation. We have already seen what are cookies. If you need more information about cookies, you can go back to my previous video. Before sending the first message, both initiator and responder, they generate cookies. Initiator generates initiator cookie, responder generates responder cookie. And when initiator sends the first message, it puts initiator cookie in the message and sends it. The responder cookie field remains blank. Phase 1 proposals. The phase 1 proposals, it sends these 5 items. You can remember it with the word haggle: hashing, authentication, group, which means your Diffie-Hellman group, lifetime, encryption. So these 5 items are sent in your proposals. Hashing, which type of hashing mechanism it is using, MD5 or SHA. Authentication, what is the authentication type? So here we will be using a pre-shared key based authentication, PSK. So here we are just defining authentication method that we are going to use. Diffie-Hellman group, group 1, 2 and 5 are supported for IKE V1. Lifetime, so it's lifetime in seconds. If you do not specify a lifetime here, then by default ASA takes 86,400 seconds. Encryption, 3 days in AES. NAT, it also sends supported NAT types. Consider this NAT types as a kind of hashing mechanism. ASA1 tells ASA2 that these are the NAT types that I support. When you open this packet in Wireshark, you will actually be able to see that the NAT types are something like as vendor IDs. So it sends the vendor IDs that this device supports in the NAT field here. Then it sends another thing, domain of interpretation, DOI. The DOI field, it tells that this negotiation is for IPSEC. This exchange is for IPSEC. Because ISECAMP is a very generic protocol. Right, it can be used to exchange, to negotiate a number of protocols. And it is important that we specify that this particular ISECAMP exchange is taking place for IPSEC negotiation. That is done with the help of DOI field, the domain of interpretation field. The situation is a 32-bit number that represents the environment under which the IPSEC SC proposal and negotiation has been carried out. So I've taken a packet capture. This has all the messages that are exchanged when a VPN comes up. So these are your 6 packets. Let's look at the first one. So the first one, it has source port 500, destination port 500 using user datagram protocol, UDP. Let's open up the ISECAMP, Internet Security Association and Key Management Protocol. The initiator SPI and responder SPIs are your cookies. So this is your initiator cookie. And because it's the first message of the communication, so you do not have a responder cookie. Responder cookie field is set to 000. Then it has these payloads, Security Association payload and this vendor ID payload. So these vendor ID payloads, you see, these are your NAT types, supported NAT. If I open them up, you see it sends a vendor ID in there. So you see these two vendor IDs are different, right? It tells the remote entities that I support these vendor IDs, these NAT types. Let's open up the security association payload. The security association payload has domain of interpretation, which is set to IPSEC. The value is 1, so if 1 stands for IPSEC. Situation is set to 1. And it also has proposal payload. In proposal payload, you will have your actual proposals. Look at the transform payload. The transform payload here, it contains your actual phase 1 proposals. So if you remember, we did set it to encryption to AES, Diffie-Hellman group to group 5. Group 5, it shows here the length of the keys, hash algorithm, SHA, authentication method, pre-shared key, lifetime type is in seconds, in 86400 seconds. So these are your 5 haggle items. And the vendor IDs are your NAT types. So your first message or the first packet looks like this. It contains initiator cookie, responder cookie, which is set to 0. SA payload. In SA payload, you have domain of interpretation, DOI, is equal to 1, and situation. In SA payload, you have proposal payload. Proposal payload tells you how many proposals are going to be there. So in proposal payload, you see number 1. That means there is only one set of proposal. By one set of proposal means we are sending only one ISECM policy. In proposal payload, open the transform payload. And then you have transform payload. This transform payload contains your actual phase 1 proposals. So this is all we have. In first packet, you've got domain of interpretation, DOI, which is set to IPSEC. Situation set to 1. The DOI tells that this exchange is for IPSEC. The situation tells the environment under which these policies are being negotiated. Then in proposal payload, you have got your transform payload, which tells what are the phase 1 proposals, hashing, authentication, encryption. So here we are using Diffie-Hellman group 5, AES encryption, SHA hash, and pre-shared key as the authentication method. The lifetime is set to 86400 seconds. This is your NAT. So initiator sends all these parameters to the responder in first packet. So if initiator has more than one proposal configured or more than one phase 1 policy configured, it sends all the policies that are configured on the device. In that case, if there are, let's say, more than one policy configured, maybe it has 10 number of policies, ISECM policies configured. In that case, you will see this proposal number set to 10 here. That this payload contains 10 transform set. That's what it means. And you will have all, the transforms here listed. Like this is transform number 1. Then once it finishes, you will have your transform number 2 and so on. So it sends all the policies that have been configured here. All right, once again, what parameters do we send in first packet? Cookies, which will have initiator cookie and responder cookie. Initiator cookie will be a calculated one and responder cookie will be set to 0. The next thing is phase 1 proposals. Phase 1 proposals will have these 5 items: hashing, authentication, group, Diffie-Hellman group, lifetime in seconds, and encryption. And then we have DOI, domain of interpretation, which will be set to 1 for IPSEC, and we will have situation. Last thing, NAT type. So supported NAT type. I've already created a short video on cookies, so you can just go through that and get more details about what are cookies, how they are generated. Once the initiator has sent the first message, it goes into a state MM wait message 2. That means main mode waiting for message to be received. That means I've sent the first message and now I'm waiting for message to be received. So it goes into this state MM wait message 2. So if you find your ASA is at MM wait message 2, that means It has sent the first packet. It's waiting for message to be received from the remote end. That's all for now, but stay tuned. I'll be coming up with the second packet. I hope this has been informative to you. Please like, comment and share. Do subscribe to my channel to stay tuned for more videos.